Hello and welcome to the Lounge Podcast with me, Pooja Chaturvedi. The television advertisements for cooking oil brands in India always emphasize on women being the protector of their husbands' hearts, ignoring in the process that women too are in the risk zone for possible heart diseases and that heart attacks are not just men's problem. According to the Safola Life study, 66% of females in the age group of 30 to 40 years are at a risk of cardiovascular diseases. The three-year-long study conducted by Marico Industries covered more than 1.86 lakhs people across 3,200 age year group in 12 cities across India and has found that sedentary lifestyle, unhealthy diet, and stress are behind the rising number of cardiac arrests. It says that over 70% of the urban Indian population is at the risk of being diagnosed with cardiovascular disease. As we approach this year's World Heart Day on 29 September, it's time to look closer at the issues related to your heart and wave off cardiovascular diseases, which according to the World Health Organization, kill 17.3 million people each year. On today's show, we have Neeti Desai, nutritionist, Safola India, who will tell us more about the study and the ways to keep your heart healthy and strong. Hi, Neeti. Welcome to the Lounge Podcast.
Thanks, Pooja.
Okay, tell us, Neeti, how serious is the issue of cardiovascular problems in India?
We've read it too often in the media and all over the place that India is said to be the heart disease capital of the world 20 years down the road. So cardiovascular disease is unfortunately one of the biggest kind of medical burden on the country, what we call the non-communicable disease burden. It's a challenge in the sense that certain pockets of this country, we are still fighting communicable diseases like malaria and cholera, and at the same time now we have to fight even the non-communicable diseases which are so-called lifestyle diseases like heart diabetes and heart disease.
It's a challenge indeed. And do you think the lifestyle and the stress, they all lead to increased risk of the problem?
Yes, absolutely. So again, it's a double-edged sword in the sense that Indians genetically are anyways predisposed to this, because one, that you know, our body fat percent is much higher. Secondly, we seem to be depositing fat on our abdomen, which is kind of the more dangerous fat, what we call metabolic syndrome or syndrome X. Thirdly, we seem to be having much narrower vessels going to the heart. And fourthly, the heart disease seems to occur at a much earlier age than when we compare it with anywhere else in the world.
And talking about genetics, now I've read some of the reports that say that the heart problems in India has moved beyond genetics. It is just not the people who are genetically prone to the heart problems, they are at the risk of heart attacks, but even the people genetically who have no such history.
Absolutely. As I said, you know, in the beginning, it's basically a lifestyle disease. We can definitely prevent it, and even if the genetics is there, we can delay, we can actually work on it. There are a lot of preventive measures that we can take.
We'll get to the preventive measures a bit later. Neeti, I also wanted to ask you, according to one report by World Health Organization, cardiovascular death occurs almost equally in men and women, though women are increasingly becoming prone to such diseases. How would you explain that?
Yes, in fact, Polar Life study shows that the women, especially women in the metro cities, seem to be the most affected. They have very low HDL levels. The good cholesterol level is in fact very low amongst women. That is one of the main contributing factors, is that women don't seem to be physically active as much as they used to be before. The only redeeming factor here is that women, till they are menopausal, they reach the menopausal age protected by hormone. But after a woman reaches her menopause, then her risk is the same as a man. But again, you know, the way things have been going, we have been abusing our bodies so much. We've been taking so many things for granted that over the years we may see that the protective cover of the hormone also won't work, and you know, your lifestyle.
And talking about lifestyle, and so we all know that we should exercise daily and eat low cholesterol food to take care of our heart. What are the other things we should keep in mind to save ourselves from heart diseases?
First, you need to stop smoking if you're a smoker. Smoking is a non-negotiable factor, as I tell my clients or my patients. You know, not like, oh, I only smoke 2 cigarettes a day, or I smoke only twice a week. Smoking is smoking, and it is a huge risk factor for heart disease. Secondly, one needs to maintain an ideal body weight in the range of where the body mass index is between 20 to 23. Thirdly, one needs to be physically active, which means could be 150 minutes of physical activity through the week, which translates to 30 minutes of physical activity 5 days a week. And again, doesn't need to be something fancy that one has, you know, join a gym and join a club and on the way on the treadmill. It could be even a very simple brisk walk. Basically, one needs to be physically more active. In fact, even if you walk 10,000 steps in a day, there is a simple, very little simple machine called Speedometer, which would measure your steps. That also is physical activity. It doesn't have to be something very big, playing a game of squash or just pounding away on it.
Okay. The World Heart Day will be celebrated on Sunday across the world. So what is that one message that you would like to give out to our listeners?
In very simple words, take care of your heart. Work on the modifiable factors. And there are a lot of factors that you can work on. So look at your dietary habits. Stop smoking. Start moving.
I think it would be really helpful. Thanks, Neeti. Thanks for talking to us.
Thanks, Pooja.
Okay. Bye. And with this, it's time to bid goodbye until we meet next week. Hope you've enjoyed today's show. You can write to me at feedback@livemint.com. Goodbye, take care of yourself and your heart.